Worship.
Okay, so getting the boot in. A lot of different ways to get the boot in. We're going to go over a few, but some of them you're going to have to just learn on your own over trial and error. All right, drape, wrist, post head, boot. When I throw boot in, I elongate my body so that I have leverage and I keep them pinned to the mat. If I don't elongate my body, my butt stays in the air, my boot goes in, but I can get high on the guy. So, I don't want to do this, bring, keep my butt in the air. I want to keep them pinned to the mat and this. When I throw a leg in, foot goes right behind the hamstring. That's very important, okay? Now, the reason for that is we want to keep them here. Okay, people throw a leg in and they go like this. All right? Well, if he switches hips on me right now, go ahead. Now I'm all of a sudden in trouble, okay? And I have no way of stopping him from switching hips because I went too deep a boot and I hooked him. If I hook here and point my toe, go ahead and hip down. Go ahead and hip down. Go ahead and hip down. As hard as you can. Okay? I'm not pinning him to the mat with my hips either. Okay? So when I get here, I want to be here. Alright? So then I kind of already got him a quarter of the way turned, or a third of the way turned, right? Now I don't ever give this up. The only way I give this up is if he really hips really hard. Go ahead. And I just lose it, and then I have to switch to here. Then I go into my figure four. But if I can stay here, I'm not gonna figure four here. I'm gonna dissect this guy. I'm gonna come up here, can't open the hips. I'm either got seatbelt, tight waist, or sack of potatoes, right? But there's nothing he can do here. What are you gonna do here? Kind of wrestle me from here. Go ahead. Maybe try to slide forward, right? When he does that, take him over. So I'm gonna position a dominance there, all right? So what I want you guys to get away from, if you learn one thing from legs this session or this weekend, don't go here, go right here and point your toe. If I just keep it curled, go ahead and hip down. See how you can hip down? If I point my toe, go ahead and hip down. It stops. Okay. I point my toe when I get in trouble. Now once I'm here, I can do all the other stuff. But let's practice that. Let's practice. Grab the wrist, drive it over it. Elongate your body, post your head, throw boot in, shallow behind his hamstring, and point your toe. And then make him try to hip down. If he can hip down, you're not doing anything. You're not doing something right. Okay? Right, one more time. I got him here. Wrist, elongate, shallow boot, toe, and I can let go of the wrist. Point your toe. Got it? Go. Now this is gonna be called sack of potatoes. This is the low-hanging fruit. You should be able to hit this almost every match. When I get the boot in, again, I'm reaching for here. I'm reaching for this. I used to never really teach this. I was always like, throw the boot and then we're here. But this is a lot of work to try to get the figure four, get it locked up, get it right, get it tight, and then start getting to work, egg beating and ladling and all that. And that's a lot. So if I could just get that foot right to there, this is huge. Now from here, I gotta can't open his hips. So what I do is I take this knee and I put it in his rib cage at about a 45 degree angle. And then what I do to can't open his hips is I turn my knee to the ceiling. Now that doesn't turn him, but as you can see, it puts him in a very awkward position. Now he's either gonna do one of two things here. He's either gonna come up because he doesn't like it, he's gonna try to sit up and try to do something about it, which I'm gonna seatbelt and then chop. And believe it or not, he can't stop this. He can't stop this. I got him tight right here, okay? So that's a real easy one. Or he's just gonna kind of ball up because he's scared. He's like, oh man, he's got me halfway over. Once I'm here, and again, I don't wanna be here where I'm like stretched out. I wanna be about right here, you understand? Where I'm almost at a 90 degree angle. He won't get quite 90, but pretty close. once you're here, you're gonna put your anchors down. And your anchors just give you support and balance to get what you want, and that is to get to a lock. Now here, he doesn't think I'm gonna lift him straight up in the air, so that's what's beautiful about this move. Now if I try to pull him to his back, what is stopping me?
His arm.
His elbow.
His elbow, right? Which is a what?
Swear word.
Killer.
You owe me 50. You can do it later.
Four letters by word.
You don't have to. That's your one. That's everyone in one body. Alright? But that's a post. I'm allowed to see it. So I have to get over that post. Because if I try to pull him right now, he's going to stop me with that post. So I pull it straight up, and then the post goes out, and I go here. Now once I'm here, if I lock like this, he can turn down. Go ahead. See that? I can even get it tight. Go ahead. He can turn down. So what I do is I take my hand and I turn it so that it's bone, the skinny part of my wrist bone, and I put it right on his cheekbone. And I just basically say, oh, look, I just found a hammer on the mat. I don't know what he's doing here, but I'm going to pull this hammer into his face. And then I bring my elbows in, so go ahead and turn away. See, he can't move a centimeter. If I go here, go ahead and turn down, I lose it. If I go here, and by the way, it hurts. Okay? So I'm not going like this, I'm not doing this, I'm not going here, I'm going right there. Using your lats. And one more. So I throw the boot in. Even if you get all the way here, you're fine. Now, you may lose this. You may have a guy that's been doing his deadlifts, and he's strong, and he hips you over. Go ahead. Then you're going to have to go here, and then you're going to have to beat and figure four him over. That's okay. We'll raise havoc that way, too. But I'd rather just do this. Foot on the hammy, turn the knee, and wait. He just stays there lifeless, which a lot of times they will, as you guys know. Get in there, lift, fall. We lift to take the post out, and then we pull, okay? If he starts bridging up and trying to come into me, go ahead, no, into me, you just kick that leg out. Go ahead and come into me. See how he can't move? He tries to turn away, and then eventually we give five, and we don't let that go.
Now, if ref doesn't give points, he hips all the way down, boom. Then we get our points and lock our figure four. If he switches hips on me and goes this way, we're gonna step up, power half, and run it that way. So we have an answer for all three positions, right? Beautiful system, beautiful, beautiful. If you can't get one of them, it just means you haven't been in enough boot camp, because this stuff's deadly. Okay, yes. Yeah, you can grab the wrist, yeah, and do the kind of Lance Palmer stuff. All right, go. Make sure the can open first.
Second potato.
Wait,
grab the wrist, drive over the wrist, and throw boot in. Now once the boot's in, put the foot behind the hamstring. Everyone should look like this guy right here. Okay, except your heel should be under his. There you go. All right. Now, you're gonna take your leg, you're gonna take your knee, and do like a windshield wiper out. I'm sorry, your ankle, don't fall yet. You're gonna do this, with the outside knee, the leg that's not in, you're gonna just go like this. Your other knee's gonna go to the foot that's in, that knee's gonna go to the ceiling. So it's on the mat right now, bring your knee to the ceiling, go ahead. Don't fall down. Just go like this, guys. Just go like this.
Mason, knee to the
like that. That's what you should look like right here. There you go. Now, if he's up on his bottom, we're doing this one first. Bottom man, ball up, ball up, ball up. Go to your shoulder like a fetus, like you're like scared of him. Now, windshield wiper. Get that other foot out. Top guy. There you go. No, don't go to your hip. This. Windshield blanket. There you go. Now that's an athletic position. Put your anchors down. Lock your hands. Around his top arm and his head.
This should be down. This
Then fall. Just fall like a sack of potatoes. Now, take the hand that's around his ear and go like this with it. And then come around skinny part of the wrist against his cheek and pull that into his cheek. Good, good. Yes? All right, same guy.
Nice, perfect.
Same guy. Let's go. So don't get into that rationale. It's a stupid thing to say. Okay. Do I have advantages in some positions? Of course. But I'll tell you what. It's hard to keep a guy tight when he's on his back here, as opposed to T-Rex arms when you're right there. All right. So there's advantages and disadvantages in many ways. All right. On both sides of the coin. That's why it's important that you elongate your body when you're on top, because your shorter guys need to elongate to get leverage. Now we're going to go into the second of that short boot series, and then I have two moves to teach you, and we'll call it a day, okay? And that's the figure four and the power high. But the short boot, and I sort of already alluded to it, sometimes they'll come up off of that. So again, this is kind of how things would materialize in a match. You know, you just kind of count them either way we've been talking. Okay, Chase? You don't have to do anything. We'll kind of just counter me when we get in different positions, okay? Bottom man set. I just took top man on. Ready? Cheat a little bit. Who keeps talking? Wow, it's not quiet now, is it? Cheat a little bit. Ready? If he stays up there, what? Come on. Every time, I got time. What do you do when someone does that? Right there, man. And be careful, because it hurts. You know, you don't want to hurt him, but boom, right there. Rest. Boom. Shower. Okay, fight you, go. Fight you. Can you get open the can. He comes up with me. Ha! Soccer.
Go ahead and move out. It's hard.
I didn't do anything crazy, I just dissected. Same thing here, first thing I do, I was proactive in jamming them, and then I get reactive. Again, I hear it, Jim, and I wait. Maybe this time I claw. He starts to move out. And now, tight waist, trying to turn. Can't get it. Boot. Come up. Sack potatoes. So, and then the next thing we're going to do is, ready, wrestle. Maybe I can't get that boot in. All right?
turns down. I try to go short boot, but he squares his hips hard. Now I go here. I can't do short boot. See that? I gotta go here. Gotta elevate him, and I'll take my four. Okay? And then maybe the next scenario is I get here. Whoa, a boot. He squares his hips. I try to go forward, but he hits me down hard. If we down, switch hips. I gotta step up. Maybe he hits, maybe he stops me here. Stop me. Stop me. Stop me. Here. Maybe he hits down. Go ahead. Hip down. Harder, harder. Take it back the other way again. We're just, it just is a chain. And you just use these three. And you can just use those three moves to dominate on top. Okay? Now those are all base. Or flat on the mat. Tomorrow, we're gonna go from here. We're gonna go boot, leg tilt, boot, break down, sack potato, or cockaburro if we can't get them, key lock, bring it right in here, locking it up. He comes back up, we pin him to the mat three times, one, two, three, tight waist. He comes back up again. He sits down hard. I power half pull him right on top of me. Okay, so we'll go over all this. That seems like a lot, but that's about all we're doing. And then we're gonna just, the last hour, we're gonna just get real good at those things. There you go, you saw it all. I wanted to give you a little foreshadowing, because some people, I think they're just sitting there and they're like, maybe it's why you guys all whisper over there, I don't get it. All right, but like you're just like, oh, here goes another move. Maybe I'll pick it up. Maybe I won't. I'm showing you five moves in 8 hours, 7 hours of technique. Okay, you can't get into five moves, dialing for five moves. You got issues. You're not very focused. Okay, you can. I have guys. I have my club went out to New York from New York. My son wrestles at. They went out and they watched Wyatt. They had no clue who Wyatt was. They watched him just rip through the national tournament out there. What was it?
Which one? Iowa or
the Mile.
Yeah,
New Way. Ripped him. And the club coach goes, do you work with Mitch Clark? He's like, yeah, I've been to 2000 camp. Because he just got good at four or five moves. And these are moves that guys aren't good at. You know, I have some parents that are like, well, we don't have enough time in the period to dissect the guy. And I understand that, trust me. I get it. It's hard to start for referee's position and get a guy pinned to the mat and start turning him within a minute. But I don't give a crap what you do in youth wrestling. I don't give a crap. People that tell me that they're national champions, I don't give a darn. You haven't done a thing until you're in varsity. You got a great start. That's awesome for you. Keep it up. But I don't care. No offense, but I don't care. Don't even text me that he won nationals. If you text me telling me people are picking neutral on him, that's what I want to hear. Okay? My son's been wrestling 5 years and he's been to 8 tournaments. Not saying that's for everyone, but I don't care. What I do care is that you get good at these five moves and you can hit them on every guy and that you can, and you know how, you have an answer for everything they have on that. You understand? Because everyone has a good high crotch. Everyone, or good single, or good front headlock. They all have good defense to that. Not everyone has a good defense to the sack potatoes. Or the figure four. Right? I tech-followed my guy in the NCAA finals. The NCAA, not the youth Malas or whatever. The NCAA finals in the first period. Why? Was I 18 to nothing better than him? No. He didn't know how to stop it because no one had ever done that before. Okay? This is stuff that you will not see at other camps. So be sponges. And if you have a problem focusing, don't show up tomorrow. All right, now, let's go out and do that tight waist. All he's gonna do is come up. We're gonna just
I don't even care if you seatbelt it. We don't even need a time. We said just seatbelt and chop and fall. Go. Yes. So the only thing is, it takes, watch, it's hard for me to get that length. You see how hard that was? Now if I open them a little, maybe, but then I still got to get to here. And don't let it deter you from riding on the right-hand side. Is that what you're asking? Like, are you switching to the left side?
No, I want to get the left leg in, but I also just start on the left side.
Well, get over here. I keep telling you, get on the right side, right?
Yeah.
Why do we want to go on the right? Get on the right now. Get on the right and get to home base. Bottom hand, hit a switch. Hit it. Did you feel weird? Bottom hand, did you feel weird?
Yeah.
Why?
I'm not sure.
Because you didn't know, because no one lines up on that side.
Yeah.
Same thing, get on. Same thing. Okay, is that home base, guys? What's not happening then?
He's not grounded.
I want you here, and I want you here. Is that better? Do you feel more pressure then?
Yeah.
Okay. But not here. I want you, look at me. So you're cliff hanging right here. Okay. Yes, but I want you more there. That's a better ride. Is that better?
Yeah.
Now you feel more helpless, don't you? Try to get him off. Go ahead. Trust your handles, bottom hand. Stay grounded though. Now look, he's being reactive. And now what I want you to do is dig in with your feet and drop your knee, try to pick his legs. There you go. All right? And then this needs to be more, boom, right there. Yeah, go. Is that better, bottom man?
Yeah.
Okay, but don't let him get to there. Watch.
No lazy.
All right, get up to there. You're like, oh, I hope he doesn't come up or any. Get within him. Look at that. All I did right there, I didn't use my arms at all. All I did was this. It might have helped a little there, but all I did was here. Push with that knee, hold with that knee. Just using the inside of my knees as hands. And then to throw these in, you know, then you go here, and then I miss it, or he stands back up, boom, whack. Understand? And we just went over all that. And we've been going over it a lot. But that's why I want you to go out when we start here. For some reason, when I ask you to throw a little breakdown into it, you guys are like, I don't know how to do the move that I just learned and do the breakdown too. Breakdown's simple. What do we do every time? Jam him. Now what do we do? Depends on what he does, right? Let me get off. Breathe. What are we going to do here? Who said it? Someone said it. What are we going to do here? Pass. Why? Because weight's on his hand. What if he sits back? Claw. What if he sits back and into me and steps the outside leg up? Right there. What if we want to pull him there and we don't want to mess with the half? Well, then run the half a little bit, then pull. Go two steps. I don't care. Because as soon as he feels the wrath of his half, now this half, no good. What do we have to do?
Swan
technique. Fingers on the ears, walking. Already, look at that. Post is up. Do you think he's got a way to stop me there?
No.
Does he have a way to stop me there? No, I can just blow him off, get him with one hand. Okay? This is a lot. We've done a lot today. But there's guys in this room that can do that better than me. And there's more than a handful. Okay? It doesn't take
So, oh, that's exactly. Okay, so if I want to get inside leg in, I can, but I have to go here and get him going forward. Then I can get boot in. What do you? But if I go, so if I go right foot, right side. That's
but you're not going to be chopping that out and able to grab that wrist and work that in.
No. So if that screws you up and you can't go left leg, then stay on the left side and throw right leg. Does that make sense? Just putting more and more on through your brain. Ah, don't get confused. If you like to stay on the left side and you like to throw right leg in, by all means do that. If you line up on the left side and you throw left leg in, raise your hand if you do that. You need to switch sides. Because it's gonna help you in two ways. You think it's easier to get a leg here or here? Well, what did it look? I wasn't exaggerating that. What did it look like? Yeah. No, this is easy though. Wham! I'm there. You understand? This, I got to bring my knee to my chest and get it in. This one, it just freely goes in. Anyone understand that? This is just simple stuff, guys. This is just about, okay? But if you're left side, the same thing. Left foot, left side. Okay? So if you're hell-bent on going left, then you need to start throwing right leg angle. Okay? All right. There's too much stuff. All right. So, did you show the move? Or does that answer your question? That was a long answer, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So let me see you do it.
On the right side?
Yeah. Let's see you get whatever was ailing you to get, yeah. I mean, try right. Now you throw right leg in?
I throw left leg in.
Okay, so try.
Just right here.
From the right side, yeah.
Boom. Boom.
Okay. All right, but what's happening right now? Not grounded.
Just stay grounded even when I
can. Yeah, because how do you have pressure into him when you're not grounded? You can't. It's impossible. You understand? Do you understand why it's impossible?
Yeah.
I mean, you may be able to, like, you're not getting much power, right? You don't start a race like this, right? You got to be grounded. You don't shoot like this, right? Right? Hopefully not. You shoot like this, right? Same thing here. Throw the leg in. Now get the boot in. Now stay grounded. Now, we will work from this position tomorrow, so I'm not going to get ahead of it. But the one thing you don't want to do right here, if the guy rides like that on me, I'll do that.
Watch out.
If he rides parallel like that on me, I'm up here. Okay. If he goes across body, I might have to kamikaze out. But guess what? If someone kamikazes me, you're here. So you got nervous. So just stay in position. Go ahead and kamikaze. Even kick your legs up. I got a seatbelt. We'll go over seatbelts tomorrow. Legalize locking hands right there, right? All right, that was a bonus for your money right here. All right, let's go back to on the base. Does that help you?
Yeah.
Covers everything? Okay. Don't ride parallel. And don't ride parallel when you're up on the base with legs in. Don't do it anytime. Got it? Do you have any questions? Okay. This time, Chase, I try to get the leg in. I get the leg in, but he just switches his hips hard. And what I did, you didn't see that, but watch me adjust. Go back again. If I try to live and die by this thing, go ahead and switch it hard. Keep going. And that happens. Now, I got a seatbelt here, and I'm good there. For most people, what happens? That happens, and then all of a sudden, you're in a terrible position, right? gets here, and I try to pin him to the mat when he switches hips. Watch what I do. I just turn my knee, and I adapt my, instead of staying here where you can keep my leg as a handle to hit me over, I kind of windshield wiper and go here. So again, watch. Grab the wrist, drive, boop. But he switches hard. Barely got it in. It's almost a seatbelt around his body. Now, freeze. What did he have? Where's his pose? He's got two poses, but where's the third? There. So you think I'm going to take him that direction or that direction? Good. Now I just want you to turn this knee a little bit down and turn that one a little up. Which way do you think I'll go?
The other direction.
This direction. So if he does that, I'm going here and I'm attacking. Figure four. If he switches his hips, even subtly, I'm going here. Okay, so if there's that huge C, never go there unless you want to bluff. I'm going here, I'm sorry, here. Can't get it, and then switch off and just pull. But we'll do all that tomorrow. Don't go into C's. He's got a C here, don't go. Don't go this way. Go that way. So I go this way. Figure four, this is the move we're doing now. Heel, you should only be able to see the tread of your shoe. If you see more, it's too deep. Notice I'm a head length ahead of him, a head and a half. Now I have leverage. Leg curl. Make my four, creating a four with your legs. Squeeze your butt cheeks, arch your back, curl your toe to stay grounded. Don't be like this. Do I have any pressure? Do you have any pressure?
No.
Yes, now I do. All right. So again, we're going to start here. Wrist. What if I try to throw the boot like this?
Catch it.
He's either going to catch it, or when I throw it in, he switches hips. Go ahead. Keep going. Bad. So what do I have to do? Elongate my body for two reasons. One, for leverage. Two, to pin him to the mat. What's pinning him to the mat? My hip, my chest, and a little bit of my hips. Now he squares his hips because he's a stud. Ah, I missed it, but I slide. Leg curl. Now where, go back. Where's his body, where's the C? Where's the C? Right, so am I gonna go that way?
No.
No, I'm gonna squeeze my cheeks, arch my back, and get driving over far shoulder, toe curls. Okay? And now you're gonna go out and do that. Wyatt, why don't you do it with your partner? Do it nice and slow. Yeah, sure. I'll talk you through it. Ready? No. Up. Slide man set. Cheek. Top man on, jam, bottom man push back, top man pull, drape, yeah, but where are you draping at? Right here, you drape there, you get his knee out, you drape here, you can't. Okay, wrist, elongate, get a little more elongate, there you go. Good, foot behind, okay, good. But right now we're not gonna go to figure four, we're not gonna turn. All right, let's get it right, get it tight. One more time, this time we're gonna jam. Spiral half, walk in a lap. He turns away, pull him down, wrist, elongate, elongate. There you go, shallow boot. Whoa. You keep it up like that, you get a good guy. Switch hips hard. You're going to end up like this. Get there first. He switches hips hard, but you just float your weight. Go ahead. He switches and then get to there. There you go. Right. Now lock it up. Good. Over far shoulder. You hear that? Now you see what's happening here? Boom. Are there any posts here? None. So let's go out and drill that, each guy on your own. You're gonna go about 5 minutes. I want you to feel it, and then we're gonna turn them, and then we'll do a power half. Go. Did it well from that spiral. Jam. Now freeze. Wait, go back. Now freeze. Look at where all his weight is. What can we do right off the bat to change? Look at that. Now, you think on the west side, this guy's carrying more weight? Coach Krause, what do you think?
He is.
All right. You start there. Oh, man, you got a big advantage, don't you? And I want you to go even a little more. I want you to go put that head right up there. All right, now jam. Go. All right, but look, you jam, and did you go to TV for zip? Now you're cliffhanging. Don't cliffhang. Stay up here. Guys, this is not, remember, this is our stance. Is this our stance? He's going to quad pod every time. Go ahead. Just go on all fours. Yep. Bring your button there. Yeah, I'm this. And this is the kryptonite of a top lesson, the quad pod. Right, so don't cliff hang. Do it again. Jam. That's much better. Get your hips square and hug it. His hips. Now, not the hook. Get up there. There you go. That's it, right there. Good rise. One arm high, one arm low. Yeah, good. All right, he stays forward, so swan. Yeah, good. Perfect. Hit the hip. Walk it. Walk it tight. Yeah. Now, break. Break. Do we want to throw the boot in yet?
No.
Right. Wrist. Drive. As you're driving, post your head and throw a shallow boot. Nice and shallow. So he needs to elongate the body and get to here. Because really, we don't ever want to give this up. See, we're going to figure four, but why do we go to figure four? Because he hits down hard. Hit down hard. Go ahead. My man, hit down hard. Yeah. So we have to. See how he lost that? So lock your four up. Go ahead. That's a zero. It's a beautiful zero. Don't be a zero. Get to a four. All right, so what happened? Did he even get to a four? Why? Where the foot is. This heel needs to be under his crotch. So what do? We adjust. We put this on the mat. We slide it up. Put your knee under his kneecap. Bend your leg. No. Bring your knee under his kneecap. Keep going. Let go. Yeah, there you go. See how he does that? Now do a leg curl. Now toe curl. Now squeeze your cheeks. Now arch your back. Now how's that feel, Bobby? Good? Alright, and then we're going to bring our hips back and we'll drive and slide. Go ahead. Yeah. Alright? So, just a little adjustment. So, that's an issue for a second. You don't have to. I just need someone on my side. So, we're here. Okay, boom. Alright, push. Maybe he pushes back. Alright, if he does nothing, I'm going here. Alright? And I'll stall here, I'll wait forever. Because I am not going to break him down right here. You think I'm going to break him down? Now, we're going to learn this leg tilt tomorrow that brings him here and puts him on his back. That's going to be awesome. But right now, I'm not breaking. I'm going to spend more energy and get out of position trying to break him down. But as soon as Krauss goes to move out, go ahead. That's when I can break him down. Now, right here is when people are doing this, which is crazy. You've got to throw a drape on, grab the wrist. Elongate. Now, I still may even be too high. I'm going to throw boot in. He may try to get me high. Go ahead. And I may get there, but you see what I did right away? I went right here, just grounded, bring him down. Then I slide back. Then I lock it up. Then I bring my knee out. Then I flex my toe. Does everyone understand that? And this is where you want to be. Now, tuck that elbow so it's easy for you. All right? Now, once I'm here, I got a runner start. I'm going to bring my hips back slightly. I don't want them to come up, so I just do it very quickly. Boom. When I get to full acceleration, watch my left knee. It goes out and up. Now, this is a beautiful thing, because now all I got to do is ladle his chin. If he hides it and looks away, then I'm going to take my egg beater and dig it out. But we'll learn that next. All right? The ladle, everyone get to motorcycle, and you're going to go full acceleration, and that's a ladle. So this is a move I invented, and you can practice it with your date at a movie. Boom. Watch the movie. Yeah. You got a double date, do both sides. Boom. Okay. But why do we do this? Because if I don't get under his chin, and he keeps his chin down, if I got to get to his chin, I can go here. But I got to turn his body. So I need a fulcrum point, which is his trap muscle. So watch my elbow. It comes down and in, and I do a ladle. All right? So that's what I do with my upper body. My lower body, back down here again. My lower body, maybe this time he pushes back and into me. I pull, three, boom. Maybe he never hits down. If he never hits down, what am I going to do? Come out, either tight waist, sack of potatoes, or he comes up a little bit, or seatbelt. But he hits down, and he goes here. Maybe he goes all the way there, and I lose my figure four. I'll just keep going, pull him right into this. But he goes and squares his hip to here. So I go four, and I go knee out. And I rock the boat, little crouching tiger, and I slam. When I get to full acceleration, watch my left knee. Out and up. See how that popped his chin up? Now how do I turn his torso? I got his hips turned. How do I turn his torso? Do I fall off to the side?
No.
Never do that. Max, it's over. Now this is like a massage for Coach Krauss, right? So I got to just quick ladle his chin out, and then quick ladle his chin out and catch it like a football. Catch his head like a football. Okay? For the sake of his neck and lower back, let's go. Dylan, you want to do it? Now keep it nice and slow, okay? You want to start TV or what do you want to do? Right. I'll coach you. Wrist, dry, elongate, shallow, bring the fore in, knee out. Over far shoulder, float, get to T-Rex arms. I forgot to mention that. You want T-Rex, because you don't want them grabbing your arms and pulling them under. Now bring hips back, slam. It takes it. Now, did he need a ladle? No, because he electrocuted the guy's hips. We don't need the ladle. Okay. Ooh, paralyzed the bats. We'll do that next. One more time. Now, let's go for a breakdown. Bottom man set. Let's see the start. Let's cheat it. All right, jam. Good. Swan. Lock it. Pull it. Rip. Shallow. See how shallow it is? It went right in there. Like nice and it's like this little cove right there. Now see, he did the right thing. He went to the hammy. Because really, we don't want to lock the floor up and crouching tiger and all that, do we? We want to just open the hip and score. Go ahead. Do that one. We want to do that and go. Right? That's a lot easier. Go back. But as he does that, he says, I'm gonna take that toe right off. Yes, good. Now we go to our four. Now we slam. Maybe he has to lay down a little, but he's up, catches it. Got it? All right, go try it. And if you need help, tap me on the shoulder. Go. Towards me, there you go. Hips back, crouching tiger, slam. Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah. Well, a lot of you are ending up like this when you got them. Now, what's wrong with this? If they roll through, am I above them? I want to be here. Okay? Some of you are trying, who's the guy that wasn't grounded? You? Come on up. So do what you did wrong and then fix it.
All right.
And by the way, you fixed it really nicely, so don't get down on yourself. Okay. But what did we not do? Go back. I mean, maybe you don't have that luxury in a match, but try to elongate yourself first, okay? So here, we'll start TV. Wrist, drive, elongate. There you go. Good. shallow. You see where his foot is? Because he really needs to be out here. There you go. Now, but now, if he's, look, do we go four here?
No.
No, why? He's halfway over. Can't open right now and score. No, no. Short boot, bring me out. Squares his hips to the mat, so you lose that foot there, so you swing the leg in. Yep, go ahead, swing it in. Perfect. No, don't go there. He's going to hit you right down. See that? Go back. Right to there, and then right to here. And then as soon as you can, right to there. Now what you have him pinned to the mat. Look how he's not grounded. So he was trying to get it. Go ahead and do it again. Yeah, yeah, but before you were here, and you were swinging it, and you're like, oh, why can't I turn it? Go ahead and try that. Can't get it, can't get it. Well, put a foot on the mat and curl it. Now go. Now slam. Yeah, see the difference? Now what's he doing right now that I told you? There you go. Get up to there. Go back to your here. Yeah, go back to, yeah, or even there. Finally, turn into a hard. Go. That. You don't want that. Go back. Get up on your elbow. Turn into a hard. Step over the top of him. Step over the top of the left legs. Alright, well, prolong. But eventually, if someone does that to you, go ahead and turn it up into me. Step over. Okay? Got it? Yeah, give me a hand. That was good. Alright, last thing, and then we'll call it a day. We're going to do head beaters, and we're going to do paralyze the backs. And I'm going to use you. Chase, I know you're mad. Put it in his eye socket. Now I do that and I bring it across and up. But I found that if you do the Zane Rutherford goes right here, right off the bat. The only thing I don't like about that is you don't get him there either. You know what I mean? So I'm combining mine with Zane. So I go here to full extension and then I pull it out like Zane. See, Zane's is really just a facelift. It's literally lifting his face. Right? You hear facelift, but they're really not facelifting. I'm gonna ed beat and then facelift and then attack. Now once I'm here, he's gonna take both his hands and push my arm off. And he'll get that. So as he's starting to push, go ahead, I reach around and I paralyze the backs. Go ahead and get out now. Okay. And I Jacob's hook here. So you know how you thumb the bass's mouth and paralyze it? I'm doing pretty much with four fingers doing that here. Right? So I get here, I do everything right. I try to ladle, but he's got flexible feet, hips. I can't get him. But I don't fall off the side. I keep the pressure, but I head beat his face across and up. Catch his head. He pushes me out. Paralyze the backs. Got it? Alright, so it's Clark. Clark to Rutherford to paralyzed pass. PTV. Go! Go, Slick! Come on! Clemson! Slick! Let's get it!
I'm not, but I just drank a Starbucks and that one. Okay, so we didn't get time to hit the power half yesterday, so we'll do that from low and then come up high to the base. And then we'll do some ancillary stuff. When I say that, I mean mat returns and stuff that we didn't cover yesterday. And then we're gonna go over 10 transitions, which are gonna allow us to chain wrestle on top. Okay. So we're taking our five moves. Give me one of them. Our five. Five turns. Huh?
Tight waist tilt.
Give me another one.
Sack
potatoes or short boot, because we got two and one there.
The assassin. Figure four.
And we've done it. Power half. Okay. So power half, I do things a little differently. When I do a power half, I don't power half like this.
Where's Jim?
Give me a hand, man. You did a good job. All right, so I don't power half like this because your wrists give out, plus the muscle goes into the bone. I like going bone to bone and cupping it here so the wrists don't give out, okay?
It really hurts a lot.
Now, this bone right here is a good one. God gave me a real good one, but I also sharpened it every night before I went to bed when I was in high school. So go home and sharpen that bone here. All the way down. All right, so I'm here at shallow boot. What I do when I take a power half is I turn my knee 45 degrees, okay? If I keep my knee here and I step up, if he just hips me down, go ahead, I fall. You understand? So I actually turn my knee 45, and then if he goes to hip down, again, I adapt to that and kind of float my foot. And it's kind of like a seatbelt on him. I don't actually need this thing to be hooked into his crotch. I mean, I almost like this even better. Okay? So I don't want you. This is a far cry from this. Okay, I'm not very mobile. And again, he can use this hook, go ahead, and hit me off and do things. So I do. Complete opposite of that. I go shallow and I turn. And again, I almost even prefer this. This is a great position for me. You understand? Again, forearm bone in his neck. Now I'm gonna cushion this so it doesn't hurt too much, but it really hurts there. And what I'm gonna do is come here. Chase is already starting. I'll go. Just ease up. Alright? But what I also do is I step up high like I'm finishing a double. Too many people stay down here and they use their arms. Is it possible to engage my hips right now? On my knees, I can't, right? We talked about that yesterday. I have to be grounded. Now I'm grounded. Now I turn them with this right butt cheek. Right? In my hip. That's what turns them. Understand where I'm getting at? Now I don't step up like this so that I have like 2 inches of drive. I'm here. And the pain of my bone to bone and the power of my hip is what's gonna turn them. Now, what I do is I create a taco. He's the meat, he's the rice, he's the beans and the cheese. Man, I've been hungry. And you can't forget the cilantro and the hot sauce, right? The hot sauce is the best. All right, that's all the content. This is my taco right here. And I'm gonna create a nice taco, okay? Right now it's not there yet. I'll show you how we create the taco. I drive up over his far shoulder. As I get about halfway down or over, I cave this knee in. And that creates the taco. See the taco shell? That's me. Now I'm here. Now, as you see, I just fell off, right? So when you fall off, because he's halfway over, I don't need the power half anymore. I straighten my arm and punch, make a fist and punch it to the mat. Now the big mistake here is trying to sink a half here. What happens when you sink a half? You come out to the side and your butt goes in the air and where's the pressure go? Away from him. Don't get greedy. Lean in and get your points. Post your hand, drop your right hip or your near hip into his face. Get your points, ref gives all the points, then you can come off and try to pin it. You understand? So don't go here and try to turn him like this. Step up high, drive, punch. Now this is no good. You can still wing down. Go ahead. Okay? So what do I have to do? Straighten the arm, he's still 90, so what do I have to do to get exposure? Drop my near hip bend over. It doesn't look like I have much, but go ahead and move. If he moves, he just pins himself. Okay? One more time. Go here. Move. Step up high. Now, if he creates that C, am I going to go into those posts? No. So in this, look at this leg. What is going on with this leg? Everybody look here. What's going on with this leg? Straight. What's going on with this leg? It's kind of a C. So what would I probably do? With a what? Figure four, right? Unless I have the foot over the hand. Okay? But he brings this and tucks this in and brings that leg out. So I'm going what? Power half. Again, turning that knee. If I keep it tight, he hips me down, I lose my balance. I got to turn that knee. 45, straighten the arm. I'm good here, but I got to straighten the arm. If you want to reach in, grab the wrist, that's fine. Drop the near hip, get your points. Afterwards, you can come out, get your fall. What happened? You don't feel good? Go talk to your dad. Guys, got it? Ready? Go. Pretty good. Any questions on that? When you drill that, you have to drill it extremely slow the first couple of reps. Because there's so many little things that can go wrong. All right? Break down one more time. All right, so I'm here. Gets this elbow out here, or hand, and I get my power half on, but he's blocking me with that. What's that? With that post, right? So I'm driving, I can't get it. I can't get it. Boom. Got it. Okay, so this is the science experiment, right? The science experiment is, stay strong. See how I can't get it? See how I can't get it? Stay strong. See how I can't get it? See how easy I got it? Mm-hmm. What did I do? What did I do? Come on. Well, I changed directions, right? Yes. That's a roundabout way of saying it. But what did I do? Change direction. Stand up. It's collar time. Stay strong. See the difference? What did I do? Change direction. Okay. So if you don't like what's happening, change directions. Now here's what a lot of people do when they wrestle because they're lazy with the power app. Go down. You go like this. Right? Raise your hand if you've done it. And you just kind of hope they fall with you. Okay? Don't do that. Just change directions. You can do that, but you got to change directions first. So go here and drive. Can't get it. Pull. And once I'm here, I do position called Majestic Butterfly. We're going to be here about four or five more times today. I scissor the hips. So here's another science experiment. Okay? I scissor the hips. And so I want you to turn down or into me. Go ahead. See how he can't? If I scissor the body, turn down or turn into me. Or even if I hang on here, go ahead. You see how he can turn up into me? Why can't he? Because he can get his power leg down. Go ahead and turn into me. And I'm not even elevating here. Turn into me. You can't plant that power leg. So don't scissor the body here. Because now that leg gets free, and now he's got a power leg, and then he arches, and then things get really bad for me. So I'm here, and I can pretty much stay here. This is a beautiful position.
but I do a little majestic butterfly. Everyone put their wrists together and then hook. All right, you ready for another science experiment? Go ahead and turn down, Hard, Okay, see how we can get to 90 almost? Go ahead and turn down. Okay, again here, see that? That's enough to not get backs. Go ahead and turn down. Now if I go here, he can slip his arm out. I go right where the chest meets the shoulder. Put the elbow in the back of the head. He can't move. This is where I spent my third period of my NCAA semifinals, my junior year. I wasn't favored to be in the NCAA finals. I was sitting here like this. My coach was over there. I was giving him a thumbs up, smiling. Woo-hoo! We're going to be out of ESPN tomorrow night, coach. Yeah. That was back when they only filmed one round. Yes. What, Connor? Better be good. That's not the majestic butterfly, by the way. There you go. Right here.
When you have it, can you scoot your hips back to get more?
You can do a lot of things. Scoot your hips back.
Like, why would you? Have it and then like, scoot back a bit.
So you can do, I don't know what you're saying, but that does bring me to, if you want to, there's three ways you can go. I mean, you can go here and lock, you can go here, or you can go here. This looks the coolest, and if you get in a school paper, you know, right here, that's pretty good. That's a good model shot, you know what I mean? This is the best. All right, one more time. Drive, and work on your technique here. Boom, 45, stepping high. When you step, your shoulders should be parallel to your knee. Now, I don't sit all the way back like this, but I also don't bring my butt up, because then he can pop up. So I kind of just hover over him.
I can't get it, I can't get it.
Switch direction. Going right there. Got it? Go. Remember what we did yesterday when we had a short boot and he's broken down to a stomach. Which ways did we attack? Exactly. Say it again.
Middle, left, and right.
Okay. And we had viable options from all three positions. Okay. We're doing the same thing with this. When nothing changes just because we're on our base. We want to be able to. We want to be able to attack all different angles. We can't do that if we throw a deep boot and we hook it. We have no mobility. You may feel comfortable there, but your offense is very limited. It's the same as if you throw two boots in, okay? If you get two boots in and you're lucky to break them down to the stomach, yes, you can attack power half if he opens up, but chances are they're not opening up. So you're extremely limited there, too. The nice thing about this, and we'll cover this in about an hour, is that we can pin guys to the mat. It's extremely important that we're able to keep guys pinned to the mat with legs in. What do I mean by that? If we're here and you drive and he starts coming up, We're able to pin him to the mat. He comes up again. Come up again. Come on, come hard. Right there. Understand, and we're able to have, he did not want to come up that third time, which I made him just because he's, I don't know if he's, maybe he's lost 4 pounds already, he's already sucked out, I don't know what's going on here, but, all right, so what I want you to do, guys, is be able to pin guys down with that Kakaburra breakdown as well, not just break them down, but keep them pinned to the mat. In our 10 transitions, you know, we'll go tight ways to figure four to power half to figure four, Kakaburra. One of them will be right here, come up. One of them will be cock and burrow three times. One, two, three, third one, lock it up, score. And then another one will be, he's up here. Go ahead. Come on, come up. Right here, boom. Bring him down. Short move. Sack potatoes. Okay? So we're gonna go over that 10 transitions. How close am I being for it?
doing well. Let me give you a little break. I can tell you. Who wants to come out and help?
Don't pick me.
Don't worry, I won't.
I'm a little bit bigger.
Yeah. So just a table. Okay, so now I got booed in, but he sits on his ankles. Go ahead. So can I get Cockerboro here?
No.
I may attack here, but even that's not going to quite get it. You understand? So all I'm going to do is I'm going to switch hips and go to here. Point both my knees that direction. I'm going to slap a claw on, make him sniff his armpit. And I stay grounded. Both of my feet are going to drive. Now when I drive, I don't have lazy legs. This knee right here is in his rib cage. It's in his rib cage driving. It's what helps turn him. I bring him away from all the posts. If I bring him this way, he stops me. If I bring him to the side, that knee stops me. If I bring him backwards, his feet stop me. If I bring him right back and over, nothing stops me. Now again, I can go here. Jesse Jansen likes going here, here, or here. Whatever you, however you want to finish. Well, what position is this?
Majestic
butterfly. So ironically, this was my number one turn in college. I got more points with this than any other. The reason why is because guys aren't expecting this. They're not expecting you to take them back that way. They're expecting everything to be forward. Right? And that's what they're used to. So when you bring and change directions and bring them back, it throws them off. Now in our transitions, just to give you a little window on this, in our transitions, he's gonna belly out. No, I'm sorry, come up. As I'm all the way. As I'm bringing him backwards, he's gonna belly out. So he's gonna be like, ah, kind of belly out. And then we can go here. Because he's gonna be like, oh, this is not good. I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm gonna Superman out of here. All right. So, one more time. Now, it's probably easier. Now, I like to do it where I'm here and I'm working, and he sits down and I can't get it and I go to here and I drive it back. But probably the easiest way is go to home base. See that, Michaels? Go to home base, get your claw, throw the leg around. You don't have to throw it in. Both knees face in that direction and bring it back and away. If you're on the right side, you're going to take it about 7:30. If you're on this side, you're going to take it about 4:30. Right here, drive back. Got it? I call this a leg tilt. Go. I turn my knees. And I bring it back, I just land on the side of my quad. Now the other thing that people are doing is once they're getting about right here, they're turning their heads. And that's what's happening. Not only do I not turn my heads, that's part of what helps me turn him. So when I'm going, this knee right here is helping me turn him. Now the genesis of this move for me was I taught it to myself. And I did it because when I used to wrestle my brother, who was half my size, he was about 6 years younger than me, half my size, when I was like an upperclassman in high school, I'd wrestle him with no arms. So I wasn't allowed to post or anything. Yes, we got back 16 to 15. Down that, my club feet. And I go, I post in here like that, so I don't fall. Then you come up, and then this is how this one started. Sit down. And that was like, whoa, that was easy. Did that without arms. Okay? But I couldn't do any other angle. I couldn't go here and do that. I couldn't go here and bring it back. I couldn't go forward, obviously. There's that one little soft spot. And so that's how I found this move. And again, you know,
knows me from my figure four, because that's what I hit. You can't say miles. I hit him a lot.
Use that near knee. Why? Because the near knee, when I say near, it's depends. Your right knee was going this way. What's you want to turn so that you can knee him in the ribcage. Okay. The other thing is go to home base first. Then you can do it. Right? Let's slow it down just a little bit. Make sure. All right. Good. Now, but then why you drop it down? Say 10,000, but with my stuff, you only need like 100. Because it's so good. What do you need to do it 10,000 times for if it's not an unbelievable move, right? Where are you at, Derek? Derek, you think if you do it 80 more times, you got it, right? You need 10,000 reps? Maybe for a lousy move. Not my moves, okay? You think you need to do this short move 80 times? Or 10,000 times? No way, man. Okay. Again, there's probably only 10% of you that can do this tomorrow in a match. Or I shouldn't even say that. Or move before. It's not an easy move. Once you get it. Okay. Or it's a beautiful setup too. Because at the very least you're gonna break down off this. They're gonna sprawl out. Okay. But you can't be lazy and you can't do it wrong. Okay, so we've gone forward. Gone that way, and we're gonna go this way. Okay. And when I go this way, it's kind of a hybrid because I take it underneath and bring it that way, and I also fall this way. So we're gonna do a two-part move here. Actually, I'll save one of them for our transitions. Can you shoot? All right, so I'm gonna put a asterisk next to this next move in that I'm not huge on power halfing someone when they're on their base. Okay, did everyone hear that? I'm not a big fan of it. I'm not saying don't do it, and I'm actually gonna teach a move from here. But especially you youth wrestlers, everyone that's youth is flexible. Okay, and they're gonna gum me out, most of them. Everyone is flexible, okay? you may get yourself in trouble power halfing someone from here because they're not pinned to the mat. You understand where I'm getting at? As you get older, you lose flexibility because you put on muscle and you just get older, okay? And it may be more efficient, it may be more effective. But this wouldn't be my go-to if I were you, right? And the number one way you know if they're flexible or not is if when you go here and you crank your elbow and it's loose, do not just go like this and go, whoa, okay, I'm going back to here. You understand? You want to understand that? All right. Notice my foot's in the middle because I'm not going cockerbrow. If he puts his weight forward, I'm going here. Twist. If I can't get him, I'm key lock. All right. But he's kind of sitting down, so I can't cockerbrow. I'm not really able to get to here, so I'm going to just go here. Now, what I do is I put more of my elbow on his head, as opposed to when he's pinned down with my forearm. I put my elbow, because I'm going to point. I need to point his chin to under his armpit. If I go to the chest, see, he stops right there, and I'm done with my range of motion. So here allows me to get more torque. And I also come up and I go top of the forearm. So everyone do this. Because obviously this is tighter than this. Everyone understand that concept? Some people go like this, it's crazy. Get here. And then you just push. And look where we end up. Right here. Okay. But again, if he's Gumby, he Gumby's out of it. So you have to be careful with this move. Here, I tried to bring him back, I can't. I tried to cockerbrow, I can't. Go here, pop. Right here. All right, if he tries to come up into me, he can't. If he tries to go down, I just tighten this up, the elbow. Got it? Go here, and push the chin under his armpit. Go. Works, it don't work well. So right before we get into these transitions, I'm going to do two seat belts, okay? And these are just preventative stuff. It's not really to turn the guy, but it's stuff that happens when you get in trouble. One big thing that they're going to do, especially in high school, is they're going to sit you down, okay? Now, a lot of times when they sit you down, they'll grab your leg and pull it in, which is very nice of them because I don't even have to seat belt. I don't have to do a seat belt. In college, they'll start pushing it away and then bring your hips up or bring your hips down, swim out, and all that good stuff. So, but the first thing what happens for most guys that ride legs is they just go straight to here and try to hang on. Okay, as soon as I fall like this to my hip, I've got to tighten that seatbelt. I got to get hip to hip. And as I do that, I grab my own ankle. And it creates that like passenger side seatbelt. You see that? And then what I do is I get in there kind of tight with them. And I block here in a C clamp format. If I go here, he can come inside of that. See that? So I go here. So when he tries to come inside, it kind of blocks him off. Now here, I come underneath. This time I go here because obviously I can't get to my majestic. Eventually I will end up in majestic. But I ride the wave right here. Don't get over eager and go here. Because he's going to spaz out. He's going to spaz out. You got to just weather the storm. And once he kind of stops, then he can reach up and get to majestic. Okay? If he starts to kind of look square his hips to the mat, then you can get here. And look at that beautiful position on there. I was talking about it earlier today. This is great. I'd rather be here than with a lion. I'm right here. I'm probably going to go climb just go with the Jesse dance. Right? But what I don't want to do again is right here, when you get hip down, go straight to here. Because it's hit or miss. If he swims hard as I do that, I'm doing one of these numbers. And we've all been there. Right? Haven't we? Okay, so I tighten it. And I weather the storm. And he's freaking out. And he may come up. And then that's it when I come up. And he may square his hips. And that's when I cockerbrow and short boot and all that good stuff. Okay?
most of the time they just spaz out, and then you got you don't want to be lazy there. You don't want to be like, hey, well, Mitch taught me this, and this is a sure. And you still got to fight. Yeah, keep it tight. Right. Now, this move out of every other move, for some reason, parents text me and say, my kid kills it with a seatbelt. And it's like a kind of a backhand compliment because I don't want your kid to kill it with a seatbelt. That means he's in bad position, he or she is in bad position. And you're probably not scoring in front of it anyway. You're probably giving just neutralizing the position. So I don't want you to just say, I'm actually going to pull him into this position and then we'll hang here for a little while. This is not where I want to be. I don't want to be on my butt when I'm resting. Okay? All right, so go out there. A couple times each person, and then when you get there, kind of like what Mario did, just play wrestle from there and get the feel of kind of a live situation without going live. Ready? Go. So this is a position, I talked about this yesterday, where for me, the Achilles heel, or the kryptonite, is when someone quad pods. Okay, people ask me, what do you do? I don't like it, I'll tell you that right now. If I have the legs in, there's a pretty simple solution. It's called a seatbelt, but it's same side seatbelt this time. I'll probably use you, that's okay. So I got the boot in. Amara, let's move back a little more. Longest way. All right, we're gonna be here. So he quad pods, and as soon as he does that, so I'm in good position because I was riding his hips well. Again, if you're like this or this, and he quad pods, now you're really hurting. Okay. So when I'm here, I'm not in terrible position if he quad pods. Go ahead. Okay. I just cinch my legs, but I also come across, so it's same arm, same leg. And I grab the inside of my, the top of my knee. Now he's gonna either roll this way or that way, whatever one he wants to do. But I'm okay, okay? Because I have a seatbelt. Now to me, this is like legalized locking hands, right? I found a glitch in the rule, okay? Because I'm locking hands, but it's just leg to the arm. Now from here, I'm probably gonna kick this leg out and whip him over this way, right here. Okay. If he rides near side, I'm going to have to go to my other seatbelt. Or if he rolls near side. All right, so understand that if he rolls far side, if you don't tuck your neck, you're going to have the worst stinger of your life. What do I mean by that? Go ahead and roll this side again. If you don't tuck your neck, you're in big trouble. Flip it out, boom. Okay. Other side, if he rolls near shoulder, go ahead, rolls near shoulder, we get here, okay. Again, his butt's kind of this way, so he's probably going to turn into me. I'm probably going to have to hit him down again and go here. If he's really far this way, I might have to scoot and get to my other seatbelt. If he gets lucky and gets out, then I give up two, and then we're just fine. So, this is a great legalized way of locking hands. It's different from the one before, because the other one's left leg, right arm, or right leg, left arm. If you have the left leg in, you're gonna go across the body with your left arm, and you're gonna grab right there, okay? Got it? From a grabby standpoint, if you don't know how to do it, Mario, you wanna do it? Quad pod. Tuck the shoulder and roll. And roll over your shoulders. It's not a somersault. It's rolling over. You can roll one or two sides. And guys, just understand this. Most people go near shoulder. Some go far because it does screw people up. See, Mario elected to go very far because, quite frankly, that's good on the kamikaze. Got it? Go.
transitions. You ready for them?
No.
All right, first one. My favorite one. First and number one way to get booted. Let's go with Drew. You psyched? Bob, ready to go? All right, TV position. And, okay, so we're gonna go tight waist, but he's gonna turn down. Tight waist, he turns down. I'm looking at the ref, he's giving me the 90 degree signal. I wanna get my leg in between, but I can't. He's not giving it to me. So I flap his arm to his chest. I reach and grab his wrist like a baseball grip. I pull his wrist like the drawstring on a bag. If I do this and keep that here, like this, it creates a post for later, so I have to take that post out. Now, right now, I'm getting backs, yes? Mm-hmm. So what's Chase gonna do? Turn down even more. That gives me the ability to sneak that leg in. As I do that, I post my head. If I come up like this, I lose pressure and I have no balance, and then he's gonna come up and then it's all bad. I keep pressure. And I post my head. I don't have to do much because he's already halfway over. I'm gonna just lock my four, slam, electrocute his hips, and grab his head like a football. Okay. So again, start up on your base. Okay. Bottom hand set. Second period's over. I'm down 3-2. I just picked top. What do you want? Pick top. Okay. Bottom hand set. How do you know? Hey, here's a trick. How do you know how far to put your hands out when you don't have the lines? On a quick, boom, right there. You got it. Everyone see that? Right there. Those are the lines. Give me the right line. There you go. The foot. We're good. All right. Cheat a little bit. Right here. Jam. He pushes back and into me. I pull. Drape. Tight waist. Load it up. Oh, come on, ref. One. You know, you get those ones and you never hear the two. You're like, come on, one. Fine, give me that. Now get out of here, Morgan.
Yeah,
you always run into me.
Well. So that's from the base. If we just start from TV one more time. Okay, wrist, drive over it, tight waist. When we do tight waist, we don't do a seat belt. He can turn down hard, and he can even switch hips. That's not gonna work for this move. I dip my shoulder, go ahead and switch hips on me. Go ahead and switch hips, come on, switch hips. Ha, can't. Shoot the knee under, load him up. One, fine. Give me this, pull that thing tight. Nice shallow boot. Post my head, elongate my body for leverage. If you don't like a figure four, you can go right into, but you know, be honest with you, I don't like coming up here anyway, because I already got him over. And there's no post, so just score. Take his head off and electrocute the hip, okay? Easy enough? Do it slowly, you need help, raise your hand, go. Try to do this like this and pull him up and do a sack of potatoes, you will not be able to do it. You have to open the hips. And I want you to drill both. I want you to drill here where we lock our hands and we lift them straight in the air and fall. I don't pull them over a post, which is the elbow. I don't pull them here. See how I can't get it? I lock here and I pull to take that post out and I fall to here. Once I get here, I hammer lock to his face. The second option is if he comes up after I can't open, he kind of looks to see if he can do something. I seat belt him and chop. Okay? So again, it's gonna look like this. Bottom man sat, top man on, jam, boot, cock a burrow. Try to break him down, key lock, he falls like this. Okay? I put my foot behind his hamstring so that he can't square his hips, and I point my toe. Now from here, I can't open his hips. Bring my knee up and bring the other knee in his rib cage. I lock, pull it straight up, sack potatoes, or he comes up, fall. Got it? Okay, go. How many more transitions do we have?
Like eight.
Eight more. All right. So the next one, I'm kind of jumping around. That's okay. We're going back to the core of 5 to 6 mode. TV, we're going to go tight waist to, I'm going to do a 2-in-1 here, a 2-in-1, which may mean we only do 9 transitions, but tight waist, we're going to go tight waist to assassin and cockaburra to assassin. Okay, so here, digging it deep. Actually, let's say I didn't dig deep and I did seatbelt. And so when I go here, he actually switches hips on me. And he gets to here. You ever been here?
Mm-hmm.
Of course you have. And if you wrestle freestyle and you hit a gut wrench, you're probably here more often than not, where they're actually looking back in India. Go ahead and look back in India, like this, okay? And so you come across, reach. I still bait them with this, make them think I'm going here, but I grab the tricep, then I hook here, and then I let go of the gut, or the tight waist, grab the wrist, and all I'm gonna do is post my head, walk, 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 bottom hip down, or near hip down, I should say. F.
That tiger.
All right, so again, tight waist. He's got to switch hips. If he doesn't switch hips, stay there. I'm not going to go assassin. Doesn't make sense to, but if he turns that hip up into me, it's there, it's clean. And if you want to, and you veterans, if you want to even get funkier and do a little chain wrestling, I try to come over top, but he brings his hips and squares up to me. Go ahead and bring your hips up. Go ahead, bring them up and square into me. Bring your hips up. Up, up, up. Come on, come on, come on. Right there, boom. Whip it over. Okay. So that's one, tight waist to assassin. Second one. Cockaburra, we're up here. At cockaburra, I'm down. Key lock, bring them under. Drop here, but I can't get it. I let go, come to my assassin. Walk, post, walk, walk, walk. Drop inside. Okay, right ways to assassin. Cockaburra to assassin, go. So we're here and we're looking for stuff. We go here, we're trying to cockaburra, but he sits down. So we switch hips, bring it back. As we bring it back, he bellies out. I step up, touch and go. Okay. What's really how this move is gonna transpire is that he's gonna have a real hard time. Like, remember when you were sort of defending it? If you do defend, you barely get your belly down, right? Because it's really hard to defend this thing once you get the training going. Once I get to about here, I do this right here, never do this because that stops the momentum, but I have to do it. Right about here, guys, he's gonna have to work like a dog to get out of this because I got a lot of momentum and he's got no momentum going out there. But maybe he really fights down hard, he's got a good strong core, and he gets right to about here and go, I keep fighting, 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 and then all I do is touch and go. And it's that easy. Okay? So in a match, it kind of looks like this. Jam, he sits down, claw, I'm looking for stuff. I can't find that, throw this over the top, bring it back, but he turns down. Oh, I almost got it. And touch, right into Majestic. Okay, go. But he's already been down. So he has a short boot in, okay, and he starts coming up. When he starts coming up about halfway through, go ahead. About halfway through, I plant my toe on the mat. I go shoelace to shoelace, or as close to that as I can, and I lift, hit it out. Doesn't take much. You won't need key locks, you won't need anything. He goes again. Hit it out again. He goes for a third time. I hit it out again. I lock my four, and I take it over. If he turns into me, I got an egg beat and lay off, or a combination. It's right here. We need to get good at this because you need to be able to, you need to be able to pin them to the mat if you're going to ride legs. Now, with that said,
You can pin the mat by throwing two boots in, but once you get two boots in, you're stuck. And guess what happens when, come up. Guess what happens when I'm here? How long do you think refs give you before they stalemate or call stalling? Yeah, 8 to 10 seconds, right? So he comes up. 1, 2, 3, lock, electrocute. He can do an egg beat. If he turns this and you can't get his chin, egg beat, rather bird. Get your backs. Got it? Go. Cockerboro.
Alright, so this is my it's my favorite, as in I don't know, I think this one works the best. Figure four three times. And he stops you. And the reason why I would abandon my figure four sometimes is guys have flexible hips. So even if you lock those hips out the right way, they're still flexible and you're full extension and they're just kind of flapping in the wind. All right? That's when I drop my foot and I go to my sack of potatoes. So I get here, I'm going figure four, but he's got flexible hips. Watch out, guys. Watch out. One. Now, if I go to my knee right now, he can keep going and hit me down. Okay? But if I go to my toe, go ahead and hit me down. Keep going. Keep going. As hard as you can. Alright? If I go to my knee, what happens? Because we talk about being what? Grounded. And having that battery current going right back into him. So I'm going here. 1, 2. I'm throwing egg beats at him, I'm Rutherford, I can't get him, he's got flexible hips. So what I do is I just drop my foot down and I go into my position. Look, it's right there. Now if I try to get off my figure four, right hips, if I try to drop my foot behind there, I'll never get it. If I go like that, and then by that time he's flipping me over. But I get halfway, but you see, I'm full extension. I'm throwing the kitchen sink at him. I'm Rutherford, Clark, egg beating, ladles, nothing. Drop it, open it, seatbelt, or he falls up like a little fetus. Sack of potatoes. I got guys, you know, I do more clinics in Ohio, more camps naturally, because that's where I spent 13 years. There's kids that just, it's like, I mean, they just, drop it. You know, in a match like situation, it's gonna look like this. All right, fight hard. Ready, cheese. All you guys can do. That's just literally combining the two moves. So let's go try that. Fight him just as hard, right? Chase did a great job right there. Gave me a good fight, and he made it realistic. All right. Got it? Go. Now listen, here's the deal, all right? I want you to, right now, Drew, fight him like it's 90%. A lot of pride on the line, okay? And I want you to, when he hips you back down, when he hips you back over, don't even entertain that. Right here, touch. Okay? No, just twist it. Go north and south. There, you see the difference, guys? No, but when you do that right there, a good guy, freeze. Drew's gonna do that, then he's gonna square his hips back up, then he's gonna quad pod, then all of a sudden you're doing that. Go back. Cockerboro. That's it, right there, good cockerboro. Boom, now go one. Now I'm gonna guide you right to there. That's all you need to do. Then touch and go again. Go. Two. Nope. Slam your hips in and you pop. Good. One. That's good. That's better. Don't touch your knee. Good. 3, 4. Drop it. Boom. Right in. That's nice. That's a great transition. That's better. That's better than I can do. All right. But you just gotta work on that, keeping that constant pressure. Go ahead, Drew. All right, Dylan. Don't let him get it. Awesome. 3 times. Ready? 1.
Touch toe. Awesome. That's it. Right there. That's it. That's it. Don't give it to him. Don't give it to him. Yes. Dylan. What happened? I said don't give it to him.
Dylan's like ready to cry.
Good job. That was awesome. Did you fight him hard? It's a great move. That's why it's my favorite. All right. I have a flight to catch, so I can't go further than them right now. We're already over 12:30. But we did miss the figure four, power half, and power half figure four. You remember how to do that? Can you do that, Dylan? So just to show what we kind of missed here. All right, we're here, boom. All right, and we're here three times, one, two, three. Now on the third time, Drew wisens up, and he switches hips, and creates that C on the other side. So we just step up. No, pull it right onto you. Pull it into Majestic. Boom, right in. Okay. And then the other one, which is the one I hit in the NCAA Finals with like 5 seconds to go, is because the guy knew I was 14-0, and I was vulnerable on my feet, so I didn't want to go to the second period. And I just figured forward him a bunch, so I kind of taught it to myself with 5 seconds to go in my career. We're gonna step up power half and bait him. So we're gonna go step to right, step up power half. Yep, perfect. And we're gonna go about 5 or 6 times and crank it, and he's gonna stop us. And slowly we're going back into that figure four. Go. 1, 2. Slowly bring that left leg back. Good. And then he's stopping us. Now he's got a terrible power half right now. He's gonna pull hard, real hard this time, pull, and then Drew wings down, and then we slam. That's how it's. I talked about it before. It's the same thing. Single on one side, that's not there. High crouch to the other is. All right, so once you do, Drew, why don't you do it? And set up both the power halves and the figure fours. Okay? If you can. All right, let's go 4 first. Good. 1, 2. Switch hips hard, Dylan. Switch hips hard. Boom, right in. Keep that.
I lost the line.
Yep, that's all right. It's been a little while since you drilled it. Now, the other one is if he rolls through on you, we just stretch it out and we. And top go to a figure four. Good. Okay. And we can do that also from when he's on his base. Jam. Boop. Shallow power half. Crank it. He rolls through on us. We attack. And lock our four and score. I love it when guys roll through. You know, it's frustrating because you're like, oh, I lost it because they rolled through. Oh, you have no idea what's coming. And really, you've got to lock Python. You know what I mean? That was excellent. Give him a hand. So this is boot camp number 3 here at this location. Number 4 to be announced. TBA, October-ish?
Yes.
All right. So a little bit.
Mid-October.
For me, I don't market. I sell commercially fitness equipment commercially, so you know I sell all week, and I don't want to sell anything. But the way I sell my camp is you guys, and you guys go out and people pick a neutral on you, and you guys tearing people up with legs. That's the best sales in my opinion, and you know hopefully you find it to be very effective. If you make 5 boot camps, I put you on an email list, and it's kind of just parents. If you've made 5 camps and you're not on my list, give me your emails, and then you get invited to the elite boot camp, which is in Cornell University in Ithaca, New York, June 15th, 16th, 17th of next month. And how many guys have been there? 4 guys. Okay. 5. Oh yeah, that's right. 5, 6. So catch me on that. And then the other thing is I'll be in Ohio in July too. So one way to do it is there's a camp. If you go to Sunset Sports Camp. So that's a good way to get a refresher. If you don't go to Elite Boot Camp next month, in July I'll be at that one, and it's only a couple hours away, right? A couple hours from here. And that's, again, Sunset Sports Camp. I don't market anything, so I'm sorry, I'm not easy to get a hold of, but if you need to and you really need to get a hold of me, text Coach Flores and I answer all my texts and phone calls, okay? Last thing I did, you know, because I flew, so I wrote a book, and I don't really talk about this much, but I brought my books, because when I'm from a town that, northern New York, it's pretty much the Adirondack Park. If you drive an hour in any direction when I was in high school, there wasn't a town with a state champion wrestling state champion, and that's crazy. I don't know if you can find that anywhere in America. It's huge. Well, first of all, it's very rural, but it's also huge in hockey country up there. So I ended up going from this little tiny area to Ohio State. I didn't win state tournament. And then, you know, I excelled and really excelled on top, and that's where I got my national title. And when I took second in the country my junior year, my dad said, hey, you got a good story. I'll hire you an author if you win the nationals next year. So I was like, all right, sweet. It was a little incentive. Some people get cars, I got an author. And so we spent 14 months writing a book that really it's really targeted towards high school and middle school wrestlers. Loaded with advice, but also an inspirational story. So you can get that either on Amazon or here, it's $10. I got like a dozen of them here. So if you want one of those, I'll sign it and do it there. And then, Coach, do you have anything to add?